Random House Audible presents The Fir Tree by Hans Christian Andersen, performed by Jane Alexander.
Sometimes we can get carried away by the trappings of Christmas, the gifts we get, how we adorn ourselves, our houses, the glamour of the moment. We lose sight of the wonderful everyday gifts of life around us. We forget the true meaning of Christmas. The little fir tree in the famous Hans Christian Andersen story learned his lesson the hard way. Far down in the forest, where the warm sun and the fresh air made a sweet resting place, grew a pretty little fir tree. And yet it was not so happy. It wished so much to be tall like its companions, the pines and firs which grew around it. The sun shone, the soft air fluttered its leaves, and the little peasant children passed by, prattling merrily, but the fir tree heeded them not. Sometimes the children would bring a large basket of raspberries or strawberries, wreathed on a straw, and seat themselves near the fir tree and say, "Is this not a pretty little tree?" which made it feel more unhappy than before. And yet all this while the tree grew a notch or joint taller every year, for by the number of joints in the stem of a fir tree we can discover its age. Still, as it grew, it complained, "Oh, how I wish I were as tall as the other trees. Then I would spread out my branches on every side and my top would overlook the wide world. I should have the birds building their nests on my boughs, and when the wind blew, I should bow with stately dignity like my tall companions." The tree was so discontented that it took no pleasure in the warm sunshine, the birds, or the rosy clouds that floated over it morning and evening. Sometimes in winter, when the snow lay white and glittering on the ground, a hare would come springing along and would jump right over the little tree, and then how mortified it would feel. Two winters passed, and when the third arrived, the tree had grown so tall that the hare was obliged to run round it. Yet it remained dissatisfied and would exclaim, "Oh, if I could but keep on growing tall and old, there is nothing else worth caring for in the world." In the autumn, as usual, the woodcutters came and cut down several of the tallest trees, and the young fir tree, which was not grown to its full height, shuddered as the noble trees fell to the earth with a crash. After the branches were lopped off, the trunks looked so slender and bare that they could scarcely be recognized. Then they were placed upon wagons and drawn by horses out of the forest. Where were they going? What would become of them? The young fir tree wished very much to know. So in the spring, when the swallows and the storks came, it asked, "Do you know where those trees were taken? Did you meet them?" The swallows knew nothing. But the stork, after a little reflection, nodded his head and said, "Yes, I think I do. I met several new ships when I flew from Egypt, and they had masts that smelt like fir. I think these must have been the trees. I assure you they were stately, very stately." "Oh, how I wish I were tall enough to go on the sea," said the fir tree. "What is this sea, and what is it like?"
"It would take too much time to explain," said the stork, flying quickly away.
"Rejoice in thy youth," said the sunbeam. "Rejoice in thy fresh growth and the young life that is in thee." And the wind kissed the tree, and the dew watered it with tears, but the fir tree regarded them not. Christmas drew near, and many young trees were cut down, some even smaller and younger than the fir tree, who enjoyed neither rest nor peace from longing to leave its forest home. These young trees, chosen for their beauty, kept their branches, but they too were laid on wagons and drawn by horses out of the forest. "Where are they going?" asked the fir tree. "They are no taller than I am. Indeed, one is much shorter. And why are the branches not cut off? Where are they going?"
We know, sang the sparrows. "We have looked in at the windows of the houses in town, and we know what is done with them."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.